So this is the WSU logo, and this is the UW logo, and in their most simplest forms, they're just pictures. So why is it when I show a WSU Coug the UW Huskies logo, they react like this? Hi guys, my name is Roland Hui, and welcome back to another episode of Community Promo. So odds are, if you're a WSU Coug and you see the UW logo, you're probably gonna have a reaction like this.
Those guys?
Or like this.
They're in the wrong part of Washington, my friend.
Maybe like this.
It's just mad irritating for no reason. I don't know what it is. I'm just like...
Or even like this.
What about it?
But why do we do this? Why do we get so heated over what's essentially just a picture?
Many claim that shared hatred can actually form connections, and that we learn to discriminate or favor things based on our environments, and that people generate lots of meaning towards different kinds of visuals. But I'm no psychology professional, so I talked to Dr. Kwon, a professor at WSU Pullman's Department of Psychology whose research interests include diversity issues and minority groups' resilience to stress, in hopes that he can tell me more about why WSU Cougs react like this to the UW Husky symbol, and how that affects our communities on a larger scale.
Hey, Dr. Kwon. So can you just introduce yourself real quick?
Sure, I'm Paul Kwon. I'm a professor in the Department of Psychology.
So what happens when people see a visual, either it be a symbol, a person, or an action, and the way they react?
Yeah, there's a process of social categorization that occur, and it could be just noticing their features. It could be noticing somebody's school colors. And our mind is driven to categorize things because it speeds up our understanding of the world. But with people, what we know is that when you categorize them, we've created the conditions for stereotyping. And we also have a lot of assumptions about what that category is. So it's really that cognitive process that kicks off some of the stereotyping issues that are really problematic.
All right, so what are some factors that cause people to adopt this bias and prejudice?
One thing that stereotypes do is it limits our perceptions of people. The other thing that complicates things is we notice whether people are in a group that we also belong to or in a different group that social psychologists call the ultimate attribution error, which is believing that people who are in the same group as you are more favorable than people who don't belong to your group, and the UW-WSU rivalry. And that's a great example of that. We belong to the WSU group, so we're going to be motivated to maintain a positive view of our group. And we're motivated automatically to think less of people from UW. It's just an automatic process, because we want to feel good about ourselves.
So I know we're only talking about, you know, what essentially are two pictures that symbolize UW and WSU, but how does a collective dislike towards something or a collective love for something affect a community?
It does. What studies show is that if our self-esteem is threatened in some way, we're especially motivated to boost the group that we're in and to knock down the group that we're not in. Just powerful effects of having an in-group that you belong to and then how you perceive the out-group.
Okay, so if we take this onto a bigger scale, how does this affect communities when it comes to race, religion, sexual orientation, and, you know, other factors?
Now we have to talk about power between groups or power differences among groups, and that complicates what we've discussed even more, where if groups are motivated to lift up their own members and knock down others, we know historically that leads to policies that really disadvantage ethnic minorities. Sexism has worked the same way. So it really raises things to a much more serious level when we talk about group differences and you add in power differences.
So I know we're only talking about the rivalry between two schools, and at the end it's all fun and games. However, when this is applied to more serious topics like politics, sexism, racism, how do we bridge the gap between these two groups, and how do we get rid of all these prejudices?
One thing that's shown to really help with discrimination of all kinds is if groups that are really having conflict can work on a project together that requires cooperation. And I've seen that. I've seen examples of UW and WSU working together on things, and then that rivalry really dissipates. That can be sort of a lesson for society, hopefully, too. The more we can foster an air of cooperation working together, I think the less toxic the environment would be to encourage racism, sexism.
Thank you so much for taking the time to interview with me, Dr. Kwon.
You're welcome, Roland.
I hope you have a good day.
All right, take care.
Stay safe. And to sum it all up, that's why Cougs act like this.
Oh, God, no.
When they see the UW Huskies logo. Hi, guys. I hope you really enjoyed that video and you learned a lot. I'm kind of curious, what is your reaction when you see the UW logo? Make sure you comment down below because I would love to know. Also, big shout out to Dr. Paul Kwon for doing this interview with me. I personally learned a lot about how we humans kind of react to certain things. And lastly, I hope you guys are just being safe and healthy. So while you're social distancing, make sure you check out some of our other videos. And as always, guys, go Cougs!